EA, do not give us legends for the playoff promo. I want current players for the playoff promo.
If you guys are looking for the fastest, safest, cheapest coins on the internet, go to my sponsor, use code DAWG for a 15% discount on checkout.
Today, we're finna do an NFL AFC playoff predictions. This is not gonna be accurate. This is just my predictions. You guys can put y'all predictions down in the comment section. Also, if you think I'm making the right decisions, let me know. So the Chiefs, their defense is very lackluster. So I think the first player that we might see potentially, and this is me talking about, I'm thinking that the car is gonna be 95s. I think that they're gonna drop 95s for like the master, and then they're gonna drop a bunch of smaller cars. But mainly I'm talking about like the 95s and the 92s. Those are the main two cars that I'm talking about. I think Frank Clark could get a 95. I know people might think, oh, Tyreek, he's gonna get a car. I don't think EA is gonna give him a better card anytime soon, mainly because he already has 99 speed on the theme team. Like, so I don't think that they could do much better than what this car already exists. The next time we'll see a Tyreek Hill might be at like a 98, 99 overall Tyreek Hill. My next suggestion who could get a 92 through a 95 is probably Tyrann Mathews. He's been playing decent this season. I don't know his stats, but I do think he deserves a card coming really soon. And his last card is an 89 overall. We got him at the beginning of the year, so I'm thinking potentially they could drop him a card. I would like to see a Tyrann Mathieu card, but who knows? We'll see. I think people might sleep on this card, but I think Mitchell Schwartz might be the next 95 overall, mainly because I think last year or the year before, he was the playoff 95 overall card. So I think that this could be a good card for the Chiefs offense, because I don't think they have too many good offensive linemen. They love giving out offensive linemen. So I think he could potentially be the biggest card in the playoff promo. Legarius Sneed is the next come up, man. I think he could potentially get a 93 through 95. If he get even a 92, I could see him getting an upgrade there. Mainly the only reason why I think he could be an upgrade is one, he's a power up player, so it could just be another power up slot. Two, he was a card that a lot of people use for the time being, like when he first dropped. And I think that it would be a good corner to be added into the game. He'll probably have about 90 to 92 man and zone with about 95, 96 speed. And that's about where the corners are at right now. So I think he could be recreated and put in the game. We're moving on to the Bills now. This is a complicated one. The Bills got a lot of players who potentially could get cards. At first, I was thinking, you know what? They got to give Stephon Diggs a card. They got to give Josh Allen a card. But the cards that we're going to go into today is interesting. I think Tremaine Edwards might get another card, man, because he's been playing really good. Middle linebacker position is a weak point for the Bills theme team. I think the best one is probably like a 87 overall, if I'm not mistaken, right? So I could see him getting that 95. Plus, he got the 95 in previous years, so he could potentially get another card. Now, somebody else I've been thinking about also, who I feel like is kind of a sleeper, but I feel like it's a good position, they might upgrade him, is Jerry Hughes. Jerry Hughes might get an upgrade. He played pretty decently this year, like a hot. I could see him getting a 95. I think he'd be a good addition to the Bills theme team. I'm not, mainly these cars that I'm looking at, they really cars that's already in the game. I really don't see EA giving like 95s, 93s, and 91s to cars who have not already been in the game. So that's why I'm going off of cars that's in the game. There is a couple players that I think that might get like LTDs if they do LTDs. I think Stephon Diggs might get an LTD, or he'll get a 95. But I think that he could potentially get an NFL honors. He did have a pretty good year at receiver. If I'm not mistaken, he had the most receiving yards in the league. We could see him getting an NFL honors card, because his best card is, I think, a 93. So I could see him getting a 95 or LTD 96. Now, potentially Josh Allen could get a card, but I feel like they played Josh Allen out so much. They gave him an 89, then they gave him a 92. I could see him getting a 95. I could see it. But then again, I could also see them going down a different route and not putting him in the playoff promo and possibly putting somebody else in that slot for him, because he already has a 92. So he would either have to get the best card, or he would either have to get an LTD. So I don't know. And who knows if they're going to do playoff LTDs. It's a possibility they could, possibility they won't. So moving on to the Colts, man. Off the rip, I feel like they played Phillip Rivers all year. This man has been going crazy for the Colts, and they have not dropped him a card. So I do think that they're going to give him a card. I don't see them giving him a 92, a 93. I see them giving him a 95, because I think he's the most important player on that offense as of right now. So I do think he'll get a card. The Colts was kind of interesting, man. Tough with the Colts because like they have so many different players that are talented, but I just don't know. I was thinking Quentin Nelson could potentially get like a 92, 93. This is how they do it, right? So they'll give Quentin Nelson like right here, like a 90, and then they'll give him like a 93, right? And then when team of the year come around, he'll get like a 96. So I'm thinking like maybe he could get a 92 or a 93 is potential. But I don't think, like I said, I think Phillip Rivers is going to be the best card. I think DeForest Buckner could have got a card, but with the Blitz promo, I don't see, like, why would they give him, like, a 95? Like, he's already a 93. You know what I'm saying? I don't see it. I don't see DeForest Buckner getting a card. Somebody else who I think could get a card is Xavier Rhodes potentially could get a card, but he just got zero chill card or Ghost of Madden card. So I don't know. They could give him another one. Kenny Moore is another potential. Rocky Sin is another potential. But let's go into somebody who I really think is going to get a high overall card. I think it's time. 90 plus speed. He going to have 90 plus block shed. 95 plus tackling. I mean, zone coverage. Do he even have zone coverage? Let's see. He going to have like at least 80 zone, I would say. I'm looking at this card to be at least like a 93. He deserve it. At least a 93. I don't know. It's a big toss-up. It's between him and it's between Phillip Rivers for to have the best card. I think Phillip Rivers deserves the best card in the set. And then Darius Leonard and then Quentin Nelson. There's a lot of other players, but I don't know, man. This is just my predictions. Moving on to the Steelers. The Steelers is one of those teams where I was like, they have a lot of potential to get cards. Like, there's a lot of players on their team that could get cards, right? I instantly thought, okay, Ben Roethlisberger, he's going to get a card. But then I'm like, do they really want to give Ben Roethlisberger a card right now? And then I was like, you know what? Let me go back. Let me really think about this, right? So I said, okay, maybe they're going to give Juju a card. No. Playoff time, they're not going to give Juju a card. So my number one card, who I think is going to get the best card, is going off to TJ Watt. Leads the league in sacks, but this is another card who could get NFL honors. He could get NFL honors as a sack leader, but he hasn't had a card in a long time. So I'm thinking, boom, TJ Watt, right? Cool, that would be a solid addition, right? But then it's another one. Bud Dupree, I know he got hurt. He could still be a good addition to the theme team, man. I think he could be a good addition. Bud Dupree may get a card, right? I got a lot of cards over here. I mean, I got a lot of people that I wrote down for the Steelers. The Steelers got a lot of talent who could get cards, man. I said Joe Hayden could potentially get a card too. I still think Joe Hayden is playing for the Steelers, if I'm not mistaken. I'm pretty sure he is. He hasn't got a card all year. His highest card is an 81 overall. So he has to get a card. I'm thinking Joe Hayden has to get a card. Chase Claypool could get a card. The only reason why I didn't say Juju was going to get a card is because he just got a card. He just got a 92 in the last promo. They could give him another card, but I feel like that's too much. There's so many other players who need one. Chase could get one. Also, another sleeper that nobody might not think of, who I think really might, you know, it really might change the game, is Terrell Edmonds. If he gets a card, he could potentially be one of the best strong safeties in the game. If he gets a 95, this man's gonna have at least 96 speed, right? 98 hit power, 97 at least. Zone coverage, man coverage gonna be low, but he's still gonna be a pretty good safety for in a box, a user. Potential, I like it. Y'all put down in the comment section, would y'all rock this? Cause I definitely would rock it and I would like to see it in the game, honestly, I would like it. The Browns had a lot of players that I was just like, I don't know who. Let me go with the best player. Obviously, I think Denzel Ward gonna get one, man. He got to. He due for one. I don't think he got a better card. His last card is a 90 overall. He definitely due for one, right? Having a great season, lockdown corner, he's due for one. We ain't even gotta speak on him, right? But this man right here, you gotta put some respect on his name, man. You gotta put some respect on his name. He gotta get a 95 by now, at least, bro. Unless the LTDs come around, this man get a 96. Come on, bro, put some respect on his name. He's out there going crazy. When he's in a game, he's a sack master. Please, EA, y'all have to bless this man with a card. It's due time. His best card is an 89 that came out month one of the game, bro. Come on, man. Myles Garrett been balling all season. It's time. We also got Baker Mayfield. He could potentially get a card, but then I was like, he got a 93 team of the week, but EA loves to suck quarterbacks, so it's a high chance that he might get a 95. If he do, I feel like it's a waste of a playoff promo for the Browns, because the Browns have so much talent, man. Nick Chubb, could get another card. Kareem Hunt can get another card. Kareem Hunt got an 89, so I don't see them really giving him another card because he's not the starter no more. Nick Chubb, he's due for one, you feel me? Yeah, I think his best card is a 90 overall with that Derwin James thing, whatever that's called. Jarvis Landry could get a card, but come on, bro. They gonna hold him on a speed, so it's just gonna be pointless. So I didn't even wanna, it's a potential. It's a potential for Jarvis Landry to get a card, but I don't know. I think they just gonna hold him on the speed, so I didn't even wanna give him any mentions, and then they just don't give him the speed that he deserved because they make it seem like Brez a slug, and he's really not a slug. Corners for the Titans, they don't really have good corners, so I was thinking, okay, maybe they'll bless Malcolm Butler because when he was on the Patriots, he had that great Super Bowl play, so maybe they can give him like a 95. Potential. But then I was like, I don't know. So I was thinking maybe they'll give him Adoree Jackson a new card, which I think Adoree Jackson just got a new card, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe not. I could be tweaking. Somebody who I think that they really will bless, I think is going to be Ryan Tannehill. Ryan Tannehill hasn't got blessed all year. You feel me? He don't even have a card in a game, if I'm not mistaken, bro. Like, how do y'all not have the starting quarterback for the Tennessee Titans a card yet? So I'm thinking Ryan Tannehill might get a card regardless. He's going to get a card for this promo. Obviously, nobody can make investments on him. We also got A.J. Brown. We got the receivers. Corey Davis, A.J. Brown. A.J. Brown was going crazy this season, so I could potentially see him get a card. His best card is a 90 overall. I could see him getting an upgrade. Even with Corey Davis, I could see Corey Davis being like a nice little 92. Oh, Adoree Jackson did get a card. So Adoree Jackson just may get a card. He really might. He might not, though, because EA just gave him a 93. They can't give him a 93 and then give him a 91 corner at his real position. So I don't know. They could do it. They would do it, though. So who knows? Corey Davis potentially could get a card. He doesn't have a power-up, which is actually interesting. So maybe they'll give him a power-up. I feel like a power-up would be cool. Even AJ Brown, no power-up, but potentially could get another card. Who knows? We'll see. Also, Tyler Lewan, they really love offensive linemen for the playoff promos. His best card is at 87. He could potentially get a card. He also has a power-up, so him getting a card is a high chance, so you might be able to make some coins on these investments right here. We on to our last team, and I think this was the hardest team for me to figure out, okay, like, who should get a card for these, right? Because I was thinking, okay, Yannick. All right, boom. Yannick's best card is at 88, right? But then I was like, do I really want to waste an opportunity on Yannick, right? So then I said, okay, let me go talk to the DBs. Let me go see what the DBs talking about. Now, the DBs was talking that talk because I'm thinking, okay, Jimmy Smith, Marcus Peters. I don't think Marlon Humphreys will get a card, right? He got a 92 LTD. It's a possibility of him getting a 95. But I think if EA gives Marlon Humphreys another card and skip out on Marcus Peters or Jimmy Smith, that's an L. I think that's an L. Marlon Humphreys is good enough to be on a team still as of right now. So go ahead and give the Ravens another corner. Give them Marcus Peters. Give them Jimmy Smith. You know what I'm saying? Give them a decent corner who can do something. You feel me? Marlon Humphreys already has like 4 or 5 cards in the game right now, while Jimmy Smith has, I think, 2 cards. And he's a power-up also. Marcus Peters is a power-up also. And he has, what, 1 card? So it's like, come on, bro. Y'all got 2 opportunities to make some shake. I think it's a good move. Also, somebody who I think could make some shake, I don't know if he hurt or not, but Orlando Brown. Orlando Brown Jr. could potentially get a card. Reason being, they love offensive linemen, I'm telling you. And he's only a 90 overall offensive lineman. Although they do have a good offensive lineman in Jonathan Ogden, but that's just right up EA alley to give you another offensive lineman when you already got a good one. But the funny thing is, what they'll do is they'll give Orlando Brown a 92 overall. So when you power him up, he's going to be a 93 just like Jonathan Ogden. But who knows? It's a possibility. Lamar Jackson just got a card, so I was like, nah, he's not going to get another card. Possibility. Maybe a 91, 92. I don't think he'll be at a 95, right? That's just not my – I just don't think so. Willie Snead could potentially get a card too. You know, he doesn't have a card in the game right now. They literally have no receivers. They're not going to give Dez Bryant a card. I just don't believe that they're going to give Dez Bryant a good card this year. It's just not going to work unless he's like a flashback. Now, if they do flashback playoffs, that'll be really interesting. That'll be really interesting. But I don't want to see legends for the playoff promo. I do not want to see legends. EA, do not give us legends for the playoff promo. I want current players for the playoff promo. What y'all think about the predictions? Put it down in the comment section. Let me know, man. As soon as this promo drops, by the time y'all gonna see this video, man, a promo already gonna drop. So we're gonna go ahead and dive into that as far as coin making methods. I'm gonna see y'all in the next one. I'm out. Peace.